Hey, folks, what is going on, man? I'm having a hoot right now. I just got into a really good conversation with a buddy of mine, and I just had to make this video real quick. I'm the Credit Savage. Welcome. I like to talk about, you know, credit cards, sign-up bonuses, and how to maximize on all of those rewards and addendums that they give you once you are in the game so that you can travel for free or pay as little money out of your own pocket as possible. So, I'm just going to get to it because, you know, I figured I'd make a video because this person I was talking to made some really good points. And I just want to emphasize that there is actually a lot of misconceptions out there when it comes to the credit card game and, you know, taking out credit. Look, when it comes to getting yourself a credit card, it's always good to have financial responsibility in the back burner of your mind, okay? So let's not get credit cards so that we can get ourselves in a hole, per se. However, they are really good. Credit cards are really, really good. They, you know, kind of are a foundation to show these credit card companies and banks that you are financially savvy and so that they can take a risk when it comes to loaning you money, you know, to buy a car or to buy a home later on. And so it's a really good stepping stone to showing that you're fiscally responsible. And so one of the biggest misconceptions, though, that when you do get in the credit card game and, you know, people that obviously are, you know, newer to the credit card game and have absolutely no experience, and even some people in the mid game, sometimes have a question or two and a misconception or two. So let me just address the top three misconceptions about having credit cards and having multiple credit cards at that, okay? So number one is that you, in order to take out a credit card, have to have some type of financial need. So let's say you're broke. Number one is saying you're broke, right? Well, no, not necessarily. I guess I can see how some people may think that, and I guess it does make sense to think that. However, it is not true at all. It's a very big misconception. I personally like to maximize on all of my spend. For example, I, you know, have to pay home insurance. I have to, you know, buy furniture once in a while. I have to pay the IRS. That's for sure. Large appliances for the house, medical bills, phone bills. I have to buy groceries. So that's a lot of organic spend that I make. And when you have a household of multiple people that you're running, it's really easy to spend $3,000-$4,000 a month, easily, if not more. So anybody that has a family knows exactly what I'm talking about. If you're single and just started in the game, these numbers may seem like they make no sense to you, but trust me, you'll be there one day. And organic spend, that's what this is about. It's just using credit to your advantage so that all that spend you're making, you're getting something out of it. I personally feel I cheat myself. I feel like I leave so much money on the table and that I cheat myself whenever I don't get at least 5% back for every dollar spent on organic spend. And that may be a high number for some of you guys, but that's just the way that I am. And if I have to make that that spend anyways, I definitely like getting something in return for it. And so if you're going to make that spend, why not get something back for it? That's just the way I see it. I'll go nuts if I didn't get 5% back for all that. Anyways, that's biggest misconception number one. Biggest misconception number two is that because I take, you know, I have a lot of credit cards or I take out a credit card debt, I'm in debt and I'm just, you know, kind of cycling through debt. And that is a very big misconception. If anything, I just, you know, kind of mentioned that I have a lot of organic spend. However, I never would live beyond my means. And I don't recommend anybody to do so. So let's say you have a budget of $3,000 a month. Well, then you should never spend more than $3,000 a month. It seems to me almost silly that if you have, just because you have a $5,000 or $10,000 credit limit on a credit card, that you're just going to go out and spend that money. And then yet, when it's time to pay it off, you're going to pay ridiculous amounts of interest if you cannot pay it out right, and you're getting yourself in a hole. I don't recommend that at all. So if your budget is $3,000, I think that's your budget and you should stick to that no matter what, so that you can pay your card outright every month. Boom. As soon as that, you know, purchase hits and you get that statement, make a payment, never pay any type of interest. I hate that. I hate paying interest. And I think you guys should as well, because, you know, I use my credit cards as I would cash. So let's say I go out, you know, to a restaurant, or, you know, I pay a bill. I would pay that bill right off anyways, because I don't want that lingering in the back of my head if I can. I understand that there's times when there's some bills that are so large that you know, you definitely are going to make a budget for those in the long term. And that's fine. If you already put in that interest and wrote that interest in to what you're going to pay, if you have a plan, I think that's great. However, personally, I never like to carry any type of balances, and I pay my balances right off the bat. Biggest misconception number two is that. And so I wouldn't put myself in a position where I become financially unstable, you know, and that's just the way I see it. I try to stick to that rule, and, you know, it's working for me so far. So if it's not broken, don't fix it. That, which brings me to my next and last and third misconception about the credit card game, which is that your credit score must be terrible since you have so many credit cards. Now, in the last 2 years, I've taken out probably around 10 credit cards. And you know what? To anyone that doesn't know how credit cards work, or how credit, revolving credit, that is, works, I can see how you would be like, oh man, that guy has a ridiculous, you know, ridiculously low credit score. That's not true, actually. I'm going to show you my Equifax numbers and my TransUnion numbers right here. Check them out right now. So that's exactly what my score is at the moment. I always have it around 800s, but I take a few credit cards out during tax season because, again, I like to get money back on my organic spend. And if it's several thousands of dollars that I'm going to spend, well, then guess what? That's how much I like to get back. If I, say, spend $5,000 in taxes, which is around what I pay this time around, well, then I'm going to get at least 30% back, if not 40% of that money back. I have to pay that money anyways, right? So why not get something out of it? I do have to pay a fee, which is, I think, 1.92 to pay USA tax. But that's nothing compared to what I'm going to get back. And the credit cards that I take out are keeper cards. So those are actually going to help my credit score shoot up in a few months. So like I said, my credit score is around the 800s. I take a few credit cards out during tax season. So it gets to the 770s, 780s. I assure you, as soon as you use that, I use the credit card, I make my payments. They, you know, that credit line is now open and it starts working in tandem with everything else. I never miss a payment. Which is key. Never, never, ever miss a payment because that's just you're shooting yourself in the foot. And it's a total myth that just because you have a lot of credit cards, you have a really bad credit score. If anything, banks want to see that you're fiscally responsible, right? And they want to see that you have a credit history. And what better way to show your credit history than to say, hey, look, I got 10 lines of credit, 15 lines of credit, and I've had every payment that I've made. It's history, you know. It's, you can check it out. You can see how much I owed and how much I was able to pay. And there it is. You know, they want to see that. They're like, you know what? This guy's responsible. They want to take out a car. They want to take out, you know, another loan for a home or a loan for a home. Hey, let's give it to him because we can see that this guy is trustworthy when it comes to money. They know how to manage it. And so, the more accounts you have in good standing, is the better that it works. The more credit lines that you have, the better, because you can keep your utilization low, you know. So if you have a credit card that has $5,000 as a limit, you know, and you need to make a purchase of, you know, say $7,000, well, you're going to max out that credit card. You don't want to do that. So what you want to do is take out a couple of more credit cards and see, you know, where the limit is. And so you break it down and you put, let's say, you know, you got two credit cards that they're going to have $5,000 each as a credit limit. Well, now, you know, you put, you know, $2,350 on each card. So instead of using 100% of one card and then some, you're now using around 20% to 30% of those cards now in tandem. And so you could then make a payment and keep your utilization low, which makes your credit score jump up. And so it dramatically jumps at that. So, you know, that's what I have for you guys today. And that's the way that this cookie is crumbling as far as misconceptions and credit cards go. So don't be afraid of credit. Don't be afraid to take out credit cards when you have a large purchase coming up. Because if you're financially and fiscally responsible, there's absolutely no reason why you should be afraid to have that work for you. And why not get something out of the organic spend that you're generating anyways? It seems ludicrous to me to get nothing back. It just does. And I can't believe, you know, 10 years ago, I was spending $10,000-$15,000 in trips with my then fiance. And I was totally okay with it because, you know what, I saved money and I wanted to take those trips and show her a good time. And now she's my wife. You know, and I kick myself sometimes because I'm like, I wish I would have known then what I know now. I would be like a super credit card whiz at this point. And this channel would have millions of subscribers. But that's not the way things worked out. And so I'm happy the way that things have worked out, because guess what? I get to have this channel and you guys, you know, keeping me company and listening to me rant and rave about the last credit card that I got and how excited about I am about the credit card game. And more importantly, I really love the fact that some of you guys are out there that hear me out and actually see these videos to their end are able to get something out of this. So thank you for watching. If I said something that clicks with you and to keep the, you know, channel going, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. It'll cost you nothing and it helps me out with the algo. Until then, you guys take care and remember, cash is king. Yes. But credit is power, baby.